We're live.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to my holiday virtual art show. I'm going to show you some paintings from around the United States and the world, or at least Europe and Africa. Places that I've traveled to and that have inspired me. And it's called Postcards from Around the World. So, my first painting I'm showing you here is of Eagle Beach in Aruba. And it is facing north on a nice hot, I think it was in February or March day. And Aruba is a great source of pleasure for us. The painting is 12 by 17 and it's on linen. Next stop, Denmark, Maine. This is on Moose Pond, and my brother and my father and I went out on a boat this summer, and my brother thought I might enjoy this view of a bridge that goes across on the eastern side of the lake, and he was right. I really enjoyed it, and we had a very nice afternoon. And this is my impression of that afternoon. This is 16 by 20. It's on linen and it's a gallery wrap. So you don't actually have to put a frame on it if you don't want. Next stop is New York City, Washington Square. This is 20 by 16 on canvas. New York City is one of my favorite places. There's always something going on. And at night it is quite beautiful. Next, going to Egypt. When I went to Egypt, I had just finished the Alexandria Quartet by Lawrence Durrell, and I'm a big Somerset Maugham fan. And he liked Alexandria as well. So I took a train from Giza and went to Alexandria, which is a Greek city on the Mediterranean shores established by Alexander. And the train had to stop for about an hour in the heat close to this to a village. and these workers were on their way to the fields. And it was morning, the shadows were long, but it was really hot and steamy, it was really great. And then I got a chance to go to Alexandria and stay in the same hotel Somerset Maugham sat in. And I got to smoke a cigar at his favorite table. And then I got to swim in the Mediterranean from African shores. This is one of my favorite paintings. It brings back all of that. Egypt was quite beautiful and the people were great. This painting is 20 by 28 inches on linen. This next painting is a faraway view of Barney's Joy in Westport or Dartmouth. And it's 16 by 20. It's on canvas close to the Dartmoor Farms. When we were in college, we got hired to kill rats with blowguns, but they canceled right before we were supposed to go out there. They didn't want anybody disturbing the horses. And we all got very good with our blowguns and darts. So there was no rat slaughter, but it is beautiful out there. And this is one of my favorite views.
Bob Conkle says hello.
Hey, Bob. How you doing? Okay, the next stop is Paris. Paris is one of my all-time favorite cities. Went there on our honeymoon. A patron of mine who had bought quite a few of my paintings gave us his apartment in Paris for our honeymoon. We went from Paris to Greece. And he also gave us the use of his driver, which is really great. So we went all over the place. And when we got in, it was raining. And we went to a restaurant in the Arab Quarter where you could see Notre Dame from the doorway. And it was absolutely beautiful. It was at night and the water was hitting the streets and it was something I wanted to capture. And so this is a cafe in the morning rain before they've opened up. And still I like the rain on the pavement. The painting is 23 by 16 on canvas.
Max Menge says hello.
Oh, hey. I would like to mention that we're going to be doing a raffle. For $50, you get a Blue Morning Glories lithograph, which you can see on my website, and you get a chance at a 20% discount for a commission. If you want to commission me for a painting, this is a perfect way to save some money. And you walk away with a nice lithograph no matter what. We're also going to raffle a painting, and I will show you that in just a second. This is the Warming House in Buttonwood Park. And if you're anywhere near my age, you know all about that place, especially in the winter. I've seen photographs where people actually swam here in the 50s. You know, people would show up, and I can't imagine that, but they did. And we'll be raffling this off for a $25 ticket. And we're going to do the raffle on the 11th of December after the YouTube presentation of this show. This is 16 by 20, and it is on linen. Next stop, Mykonos, Greece. This is 34 by 24 on linen. It's mostly acrylic, but there is a little bit of oil paint on this one as well for the bougainvillea. And there are just so many streets. It's like a maze in Mykonos, and there are steps and doorways and lots of bougainvillea. It grows like a weed all over the town. It's quite beautiful. Stoning too much. Next stop is St. Cloud, Florida. We stay in a place on a lake called Toho, and there's a river or two that go flowing into it. And the light there, especially in January, is quite beautiful, especially around sunset, and that's what this view is. It's looking north, and it's 16 by 20, and it's on canvas. This September, we went to Mykonos, and some of you may have seen the videos that I was sending back. And this is Ioannis at Megaliamos Beach on Mykonos. It's a great place. Excellent food, beautiful view, and one of our favorite places to go. We've been there for weddings, birthday parties, drinking parties, and just nice afternoons with friends. So we'll stay on Mykonos for a little bit. This is a very famous church called the Paraportiani. It's actually four churches on the base and a fifth church on top. It was started in the 1420s and completed in late 1600s. It's considered one of the two or three most photographed churches in the world. And it changes color with whatever the sky is doing or whatever the sea is doing. So one of my favorite paintings. This painting is on linen, and it's 24 by 30 inches. One more of Mykonos. This is a view of Mykonos town. Those windmills you saw in the other painting are, this is the other side. This painting is 18 by 24 on linen, and it's a view of the harbor and the beach, and these are where all the tavernas are. It's quite a friendly little place. These windmills are these windmills, just on the other side. I'd like to mention that there's no supply chain problem here with art, and there's plenty of time to order. You can even commission a painting, and depending on the subject and how big you want, you might even be able to get that before Christmas, certainly by January. So now we're going to go to Italy. When I turned 50, my fiance, me and my parents did a little tour of Italy. And this is one of the paintings, or one of the views that inspired a painting. This is St. Mark's Square. That's the bell tower at the Basilica. And this was March, so the light was very interesting. It was coming in at a very shallow angle, and it was lighting everything up in beautiful ways. And we had just every place we looked, I wanted to paint. So I got a number of very nice paintings from this trip, and we had a very, very good time.
Charles says, the slanted light is captured so well.
Oh, thank you. We'll be showing all these paintings again shortly, so if you want to see something again, you will. Now, when I was in college, I met a guitar maker by the name of Nick Apollonio, and he had a shop up in Camden, Maine. This is not Camden, Maine, but my father, who went to Bowdoin, told me about this lighthouse at Portland Head, and so I went there on the way up to Camden, and was taken by it. And this is the Portland Head Lighthouse in the evening, and I had a lot of fun doing this one. It brought back very good memories. I would like to mention that the links for the raffle tickets are on the comments. So if you're looking for a place to just tap into, that's the place to go. My brother and my sister-in-law bought these flowers for my mother this spring. And I've been wanting to do a still life for a while, so this is kind of a postcard from my mother's living room. It is on linen, and it's 19 by 14. And every once in a while, I like to do something kind of traditional. And so, this is what it is. We'll be representing this on December 10th on YouTube at the same time. And we'll have the drawing for the raffle tickets on December 11th, where we'll announce the winners. So we'll take a quick journey through all of these again. This is Denmark, Maine, on Moose Pond. It's 16 by 20 on linen. This is also what they call a gallery wrap, so the edges have been painted. This is St. Cloud, Florida. It's 16 by 20 on canvas.
Ken, is a gallery wrap challenging to do?
It is when you're stretching and gessoing. When painting it, it's not that big a problem. It's just a little border, and you just extend everything, and it's kind of fun. But getting the linen or canvas around the frame so that the staples or tacks are on the inside. That can be a bit of a challenge. I don't do it very often. There's Eagle Beach and Aruba, looking kind of north. Well, Charlie, there's actually dead fish everywhere. It's a Zen painting. These are field workers in Egypt or on the way to Alexandria. This is the warming house at Buttonwood Park. This is the painting that we are raffling off. It's 16 by 20. It's on linen.
Was this early morning at Buttonwood Park? Do you remember?
That's a good question. No, I think it was in the afternoon. Yeah, it was afternoon. Yeah, because the light's coming from the west. I had to think about that.
The painting in Alexandria, was that early morning?
Yes, that was early morning. It was still very hot. No air conditioning on the train. Here's Paris, a cafe in Paris, in the morning rain. Not quite set up yet. This is Ioannis at Megaliamos in Mykonos. It is 16 by 20 on linen. This is New York City at night in the rain. I call this a night out. A young couple out with their umbrella at Washington Square in New York City. New York is unlike any other city that I've ever been to. Absolutely gorgeous. Lots of good food, lots of good music, art, and great people. Portland Head, Maine, on the way up to buy my first homemade guitar. And that doesn't mean that it was not a good guitar. I had saved for a year and a half to buy a 12-string guitar made by Nick Apollonio in Camden, Maine. And it was a very nice guitar. This is a view of Barney's Joy. It's 20 by 16 on canvas. This one I call the border. This is between Texas and Mexico. There's a poem by Robert Frost called The Mending Wall. And it starts with, "There is something I think that doesn't love a wall." I like the composition. It's 16 by 20 on linen. You can make your own judgment about borders and walls. The poem, by the way, by Robert Frost is worth reading. It's deceptive and not very conclusive. Here's a view of Mykonos town. It's 18 by 24 on linen. This is a church in Mykonos called the Paraportioni. It took 200 years, slightly over 200 years to complete it. It was started in the 1420s, and it, last time they put a new addition on it was late 1600s. There's a green doorway with bougainvillea. It's 30 by 24. 34 by 24. It's on linen. And I would like to remind everybody that all of these paintings are available for purchase. Make a very long-lasting Christmas gift. Just give me a call. We can talk. Here's a view of Venice, St. Mark's Square. It's 29 by 39 on linen. to thank you all for coming out. I want to thank Vicki and Nick for taking care of business behind the camera. This is the painting that we are raffling off. $25 ticket will get you a chance to take this home. For $50, you will get a lithograph, which you can check out on the website, artistkenrichards.com, and a chance to get 20% off any commission that you might want to do. I love doing commissions. It's like a teamwork approach to making art, and it becomes a little more personal if you are involved with the artist. And I really enjoy that. So if you have something that you would like painted, some favorite area in this around here, or whatever you like, give me a call. We can talk. Thanks again for coming.